One of the dangers when using personal narratives, especially in a course or research project, is that you're only using one personal narrative and a range of other kinds of information. That personal narrative tends to become stereotypical. It tends to speak for a larger group than a personal narrative really can. The personal narrative is personal. It is one person's opinion about something. We often interpret them as representing a range of people, but they really are only personal. How much can we trust personal narratives? How can we tell if something really happened? When someone is writing a personal narrative for a particular purpose, it's hard to imagine why they would lie about unrelated information. For instance, Glückel is writing about her activities as a merchant. We can't judge that they are true or not. It's very difficult to figure out what would be the point of lying, because the purpose of this memoir is not to talk about her mercantile activities. She's not trying to justify herself for a merchant's board when there might very well be a reason for somebody to lie, how many pearls they've sold or the exact trade that one conducted. That's not her purpose here. Her purpose is to think about her own situation with God, and she writes a lot about God. She tells long stories that aren't really her stories. They are stories that have been handed down to her, and she hears them orally and repeats them about God and God's handling of things in little vignettes. Her 19th century editors weren't interested, so they don't include it. But now her complete memoirs are available.